Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Wow, I have lots of energy today. I wanted to start off by saying I am so sorry that I did not upload like at all last week. I had a super busy week. I had a really busy weekend. I was out of town and I just was not able to film last week, but here I am today for a new video. Today's video, I wanted to do my kind of what I call my days off kind of makeup look. I do have a job now. I work at a spa here on the island and we are open Tuesdays through Saturdays. So all those days I'm going to work with a full face of makeup on. So basically when I'm not working on Sundays and Mondays, I'm just doing things besides work like schoolwork, going to church, errands, things like that. This is the makeup that I wear. I just have been living in this makeup look lately. Like I said, anytime you catch me on my days off on Sundays or Mondays, this is the look that I have on every single time. My go-to, I absolutely love it. It's not heavy, no liquid foundation, no contouring, nothing like that. It is just simple. It enhances your natural beauty and your features, and it's my no makeup makeup look. Also totally wear this look for whatever you want to wear it for. You know, it's great for the school day because it's not super heavy or dramatic or anything like that. It's just quick, easy, and natural and easy to recreate. Today wearing a ring, a t-shirt, and my Loci bracelet. I'm not at work. I'm in a t-shirt, running shorts, sweatpants, yoga pants. Also not wearing a full face of makeup, so I figured if I'm doing the makeup that I would wear on my days off, I'm going to be wearing the outfit and jewelry that I would normally wear on my days off. Because this is real life, people. So without further ado, because I keep on rambling, I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. I love it so much and I love you so much. I hope you guys are having a great October. And I will see you guys in just 1 second with no makeup on. And really quickly, this is just the makeup look up close because I realized I did not show you guys throughout the whole video. This is just what we have going on. All right, so the first thing I do is start out with like my favorite concealer ever from the drugstore. I love like all the Maybelline concealers. This has been the one that I've been using for the past couple of months. It's the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer. And I'm in the shade Light Pale. So seeing how I'm not using foundation today, I basically used this all over the place. I put it under my eyes in a triangle shape and I carry it to the outer corner of my lids to conceal that darkness. When I'm not wearing foundation, I go pretty heavy-handed on the concealer, but this stuff gives incredible coverage. I absolutely love it. Here in another like upside down triangle shape between my eyebrows, as I have like a few little breakouts and then just right above the brows, I'll go a little bit down the nose. I'll hit the cupid's bow, the chin. Also cover up any blemishes. My skin looks really good right now. The camera always makes it look really red. I'll just put this on any little problem spots or areas that are a little red. I'll just kind of tap it around. A little bit of scarring. Blending out this concealer, sorry I look so funny, with my Sedona Lace 217 brush and my fingers. Always want to make sure when you're blending your concealer to always take it into the inner corner, because that is where most of the darkness comes from and starts, is right there on the inner corner. I think I've said that quite a few times now on my channel, but hey, gotta preach it till you know it. So now beneath my eyes is pretty much concealed. I always use my finger for that area, and then I'll use the 217 for the little blemishes and other spots that I wanted to highlight. By the way, there's Cooper. He tends to hang out in the background of like all my videos now, so he's just gonna J-chill there. Okay, so the next thing that I do, and this is just for my under eye area, I go in with what I call the grandma powder, and it's not actually called grandma powder, but it basically smells just like your grandma's perfume, or at least my grandma's perfume. Like the White Diamonds is so heavily scented, but that's what it smells like. But it's actually the Airspun Loose Face Powder, and I use the shade Translucent Extra Coverage. And I'm just gonna pop this beneath my eyes. If you still see the product sitting there, that is okay, because we're like low-key baking right now. Now that our grandma powder is sitting on our face and it's all over my black t-shirt, next thing I do is another powder product, and this is my favorite powder foundation of life that I have tried, and I've tried like 3 or 4, and this is my favorite by far. These are like the little samples, which are basically the size of the MAC pan eyeshadows, but I'm gonna be buying the full size one soon because I love it so much and my samples are like almost out. It's the Glow Minerals Pressed Base, and this is basically their powder foundation. This stuff has incredible coverage. I don't get oily. It's literally amazing. Like, I love it so much. I am in shade Natural Medium, but I'm going to mix a little bit of Honey Light. And I go back and forth between, like, I like to stamp the product down first with a little cosmetic wedge, and then I buff over it with a little bit more product with my e.l.f. Studio powder brush. It is just a powder foundation with amazing buildable coverage. Like, it's incredible, the coverage of this stuff. My skin's been really clear here lately because of the routine that I've been on, so I really don't need like full coverage liquid foundation all the time, which is when this stuff comes in handy. Alright, so now that most of the product is laid down with the little sponge that I like to use, and by the way, don't keep these things. Literally keep it for a couple of days, chuck it out, and then get a new one because they can really harbor bacteria. Then I go back in with the same 2 shades and my little e.l.f. powder brush, and I go back over my face again, add a little bit more extra coverage, and just buff it all together. And also, now that we're using the brush, I'm going to go around the eye area and sweep away the excess grandma powder. This stuff is so natural. I take it down the neck. All right, so now we're going to go on in with the eyebrows, aka the frames of the face. I have been obsessing with this NYX Micro Brow Pencil. It reminds me a ton of my Anastasia Beverly Hills one. It's great. There's a spoolie on one end and a pencil on the other, and I'm in the shade brunette because I have those awesome black brown eyebrows. And I just kind of fill in the little sparse spots. I'll add a little bit of shape to the front of the brow. Then once they're filled in, I go back and comb them through just to blend the product in with my natural hair. And that's all, folks. That's as far as the eyebrows go. Eyeshadow-wise, basically how... Okay, so basically as far as the eyeshadow goes, I just basically do whatever I'm feeling. I do not use eyeshadow primer on makeup days like this because I do not like doing a full-on eye makeup look with makeup like this. I keep it light, I keep it simple, I keep it natural. I will either use like 1 or 2 matte eyeshadows or like 1 shimmery shade and that's it. It's not the same thing every time, but what I do most of the time is use Wet n Wild's Brulee, which is a matte cream color, and of course Milani's Bella Cappuccino, which is like my favorite light matte nude kind of color. I'm gonna take Brulee, and this is a very pigmented eyeshadow, like it's super super pigmented, and I use just a little tiny Sedona Lace 863 brush, and I just put this all over the lid, through the crease, and all the way up to the brow bone. I'll take a more precise brush and the Bella Cappuccino, and really lightly I will just run this through the crease for just a little bit of dimension. This really helps open up my eyes and gives them a nice little shape. A moment of appreciation for how much I've used these 2 colors. This is what Brulee looks like. Like, look at that pan. I see it, do you? And then this is what Bella Cappuccino looks like. You can't see the pan, but I've definitely put a big dip in it. You guys know what's stuck in my head right now? Why you always lying? Oh my gosh. Why you always lying? When your hair gets stuck in your cartilage. Alright, now this past like week I have been obsessing over gel eyeliner, and I've been using my MAC Black Track Fluid Line like every single day. I've been so obsessed with it, but with a look like this, I don't think I want to wear eyeliner today just because it's really simple and natural. So I'm just leaving my eyeliner off and just doing this look as I would normally do it. Alright fam, we almost done, don't you worry. Just so my face isn't so flat and one color, because basically all we did was like conceal everything. I don't really wear blush and highlighters and things like that when I'm only wearing like powder foundation and concealer. I don't know, I never do. I just like to bronze the forehead a little bit and like around my jaw, just to give a little bit of dimension, and so I don't look so pale. Using my Hoola bronzer, of course, and my big ol' e.l.f. complexion brush. I like to just put this around the temples. Anyhow, like what we call no makeup makeup, or like enhancing your natural beauty, or like playing with your features. It's funny how sometimes that takes the most work. Like, it's just like the funniest thing, like what we call no makeup makeup takes like the most products. Like, oh, no makeup makeup, most people just think mascara, but no, we're over here with like our bronzer and all sorts of stuff. I don't know, I think it's funny how what we call natural is a lot more work than some people would think. Next, I do lashes, then lips, then we're done. You guys already know what I do to my lashes if you've been watching my channel for a while. It's still the same exact routine. I curl them, then I apply to my upper lashes the Maybelline Rocket Volume Express Mascara, and then I use the Wet n Wild Mega Length on my lower lashes. I'm just gonna skim through this really quickly because you guys know how to do your mascara. It's literally no big deal. Hey, what's up? Hello, I now have my eyelashes done, and I feel like I can see whenever my eyelashes are on because my eyes go from like this to like this, and I'm like, okay, much better. So then, once you have your mascara on, you are practically done. Go ahead and do your lips however you want. Whenever I wear makeup like this, I never wear lipstick, ever. It's always lip gloss or lip balm. So today, I'm using my secret weapon. I call this my secret weapon because I literally love this so much. It's the Maybelline Baby Lips in the shade Grapevine. But for me, this color is my lips but better. Literally, it's like a shade or two darker than my natural lip color, but it's moisturizing and glossy, and it makes my lips look fuller, and it just brings life to them. I literally love this product. I'm just gonna pop this on. And that, my friends, is basically it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to comment down below what you thought of this video, if you liked it, any further video requests you guys might have. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up. It would literally mean the world to me. It helps me out so much. I hope you guys have a great day, a great night, and I'll talk to you guys soon. I love you all so much. Bye, guys. Mwah.